A new poll from Yahoo News and YouGov found that Trump voters are very concerned about racism, but against white people. I mean it. The survey of 1,638 US adults conducted from July 13 to 17 showed that among 2020 Trump voters, 62% say that racism against Black Americans is a problem today, while 73% say that racism against white Americans is a problem. So an 11% gap more people say against white Americans. Additionally, asked how much of a problem racism currently is, just 19% of Trump voters describe racism against Black Americans as a big problem. Twice as many, 37%, say racism against white Americans is a big problem. It's very difficult, to look at those numbers, look at Trump voters as a real reflection of America. Trump voters, self-identified Republicans, are the only demographic groups identified by the poll who are more likely to say that racism against white Americans is a problem than to say the same about racism against Black Americans.
All right, guys, this is a giant problem, not just for the Republican Party, but for the country. So first, I'm so despondent about the state of the Republican Party that I'll take some of these numbers as a good result. Like 19% of Trump voters describe racism against Black Americans as a big problem. I didn't think it was that high. Okay, at least one out of five Republicans think that there might be racism against Blacks in the country. I'll take it as a partial win. 62% say that racism against Black Americans are a problem today. 62% of Republican voters. Well, okay, all right. You know, it could be worse. Now, having said that, that's the upside. The downside is 73% think that racism against whites is a major problem, is a real problem in this country. Wow. But before you judge the Republicans too harshly, let's look at the overall numbers. I'll give you one more here. A majority, 51% of white Americans, that's all white Americans, for instance, think racism against people who look like them is a problem. But overall, far more white Americans, 72%, say racism against Black Americans is a problem. So most Americans, 72%, say, come on, get real. Racism against Blacks is of course worse, right? But 51% say that there's racism against whites. So that is very concerning. And it's concerning on two fronts. So number one, is there massive racism against white people in this country? No, there is not, okay? And so the fact that they are wrong about that and headed in the wrong direction and so worried about it, that a big chunk of Republican voters think it's a major problem, right? That's problematic. The second problem is that apparently, for whatever reason, and it's not just propaganda, they are concerned that there is now, they are going to be discriminated against. And look, and a lot of people get angry over this, but I think one of the problems here is how long affirmative action has lasted. And it was absolutely necessary in the beginning, but now you've got more than half of white Americans saying, I think there's racism against me, against us. And that is not a healthy place for the country to be. And these numbers get worse almost every day.
Well, I thought we were going to end on agreement with Biden and Pelosi earlier, but we're going to end on disagreement on affirmative action. To blame this on affirmative action rather than what Donald Trump and his quote unquote movement have facilitated in terms of having it be okay to show racism, having pointing out at every campaign stop that his people are aggrieved by the US government, that's what creates this. He has sown this in this country. So it's a terrible thing. We can't blame this at all on affirmative action. But the encouraging line here, though, is that at least you have so many of these people acknowledging that there is racism against Black people, which you wouldn't have known otherwise.
Yeah, look, I don't want people to misinterpret me. I think Trump has driven tons and tons of racism for the reasons that Michael states, and he eggs this kind of opinion on, and it is overall enormously unjustified to think that there's racism against white people in this country. I'm just saying that affirmative action, I believe, is a contributing factor to that. And you could say, no, people are used to it. They think it's perfectly great. They don't, and no white person thinks they're gonna lose their spot in a job or a college because of affirmative action. No one has caught feelings over that. I would disagree. I think some have, and I don't think it's helpful to the country.
No, I don't say absolutely what you just said. I don't paint me like that. What I was saying though is on balance, I think it has been better for the country and better for race relations because it has made it better to be a minority in this country. And I don't think it's done its work yet, that's all.
Yeah, and Michael has the majority opinion of the left there. I'm in the minority. In the country, now the country has turned a little bit against affirmative action, a little bit past 50% saying we should end, you know, the Supreme Court was essentially right. But among the left, Michael speaks for that community more. They still believe that affirmative action is productive and the right way to go.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.